mouth with a bit, take your weight back. Now your weight's off your forehand, you can take your shoulders and go left. And you can take your shoulders and go right. And now we're gonna change the bend to a right bend. And he's not bending, because he's not moving his ribs over and taking his left hind leg and putting it underneath himself. So I can take the tip of my whip and touch the left. Now he's bent. Now he's putting his hind leg under. Now his head goes down. As soon as a horse puts a inside hind leg under their center line, their head goes down and they relax. This is important to know if you're a trail rider. So instead of desensitizing your horse so he doesn't spook, why don't you teach him this so that when he's afraid, you can help him relax? Because when you desensitize a horse and he stands still and you reward him because he stood still, he's still not relaxed inside. I want to help my horse. So I need to teach him that I can bend him and ask him to put his inside hind leg forward and under his center of gravity. And that causes him to put his head down and relax. And she, that's what she does.
Can I say something? You know, when we're doing, and movements to do too, what creates relaxation in a muscle? What's one big thing? To stretch it. If you stretch a muscle, isn't that muscle now more relaxed? So when we're doing this, we're going from one bend and then we're going into another. And we're not holding one bend. Like if I want to create more flexibility in me, you know, if I go down into a movement and then come up and then go back down, that stretches my muscles, right? Or I could just go down and stay there. Would my muscles tighten or would they create more flexibility if I just stay down there? They started to tighten, wouldn't they? So by going in and out of a bend, that helps that horse create some of that flexibility through his body. So when I take this horse and I ask him to go away from me and go to the right, I'm gonna ask that right front foot, ask him to shift back, now step right front foot to step over, left front foot, go across. Now you see, he steps it over and he's really stepping it over, there, there. Now I go forward and now I change the bend. And now I ask the left front foot to step over to the left. Step forward. So I'm changing the bend. And that's going to be really important through that middle part, because how many times do you guys go down the trail and it changes the bend? You need to hang it out. So if I'm gating, if my horse is nice and flexible and loose and knows how to bend, when I go down that trail, I can be in and out and I roll with the feet.